they got infected to COVID after taking the second dose, second or
Correct,
third day.
correct, correct.
It happened. Huh? So there was a dilemma, but then I decided it, I have to take it, then you take it, or decided not to take. So ultimately, since it was to be second dose, was to be second, so yesterday I managed to go to the hospital and got it done.
जैसे साबिर भाई कहते हैं ना, जो एक कदम ले लिया तो अब दूसरा भी ले ही लो.
ले ही लेना चाहिए. करेक्ट करेक्ट बहुत ज्यादा. तो दैट वेरी अनफॉर्चुनेटली नथिंग हैपेंड. इन अभी तक ठीक है, सो एवरीथिंग इज ऑल राइट.
अच्छा, वेरी गुड.
हां
नमस्ते एवरीवन.
नमस्कार.
नमस्ते सर. नमस्ते.
लेट अस स्टार्ट द सेशन विद द चैंटिंग ऑफ ओमकार. Am I clearly audible? Because I am not earphone.
Yes, sir.
So we will go ahead. The chantings of Om, requesting you all to sit with your spine erect, with your shoulders proper. Closure of your eyes, observing your breathing. Slowly So last class we started the Yoga Sutra discussing about Anushasan, how yoga is a discipline that is to be followed, and what is the understanding of the word Atha. With this understanding, going ahead with the defining of yoga as chitta vritti nirodha, coming to the result as seer, the practitioner, the aspirant gets established in his original. The original form is none other than the Purusha. He goes on to say, one who does not get established is in vrittis, and then says vrittis are fun, they are painful, they are non-painful. We had a nice discussion on what are the painful vrittis, what are the non-painful vrittis. Any vritti can be both painful as well as non-painful. It is only the situation, understanding, which makes the vrittis painful as well as non. After a good discussion, what is pramana, that is valid knowledge, what is viparya, invalid or you can say wrong knowledge, the example of rope and the snake, vikalpa, the example of akash in the sky, Nidra, as we are talking about, very sound, dreamless sleep, deep sleep, you can say. And then we are talking about Smriti, memory. How these five vrittis affects us, we had a nice discussion in the previous class. After explaining all this up to 11th sutra, the 12th sutra says, Abhyasa Vairagya Abhyam Tan Nirodha. So, when we say अभ्यास इट इज नॉट जस्ट प्रैक्टिस वी शुड से इट इज अ कंटिन्यूस प्रैक्टिस व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट वैराग लिटरली इट मीन्स डिटैचमेंट और डिस्पैशन तन्निरोधः continuous practice and detachment will lead to that cessation which we were talking about citta vritti nirodha. Having discussed all in detail the five modifications of the citta vrittis, in this sutra Patanjali is giving us a general understanding of how to stop this citta vrittis. Dear friends, practice that is abhyasa or should say continuous practice and detachment vairagya, they both are supposed to be adopted simultaneously. See, regular practice is like providing fuel which is essential to go ahead to rise higher and higher on our path of spirit. But when we are on this path, what is more important along it cuts off the knots. इतने हमारे बंधन है ना जो हम बांध कर रखते हैं. All these knots, bandhans, are cut off by this detachment or vairagya. And it will make sure that it is providing us that required lightness to rise again more higher. नहीं तो ये वजनदार बोझ के तले हम दबते हैं जो रोजमर्रा की जिंदगी के अंदर जितने भी अटैचमेंट के साथ में हम जी रहे हैं इसका भार इतना भारी है कि हम अपने आप को हायर लेवल हायर प्लेन्स के ऊपर लेके जाने कोशिश तो करते हैं. इंसान तय तो कर लेता है कि मुझे डायबिटीज है तो मुझे जलेबी नहीं खाना गुलाब जामुन तय तो कर लेता है. लेकिन जब खुशबूदार मिठाई तो जलेबी की खुशबू उसको कितना लगता है इतने दिन से नहीं खाया आज एक खा लूंगा तो क्या फर्क पड़ता है. एंड देन ही गोज अहेड एंड वैराग्य का क्या हुआ. सो दिस इज द केस विद एवरी वन ऑफ नाउ हियर टू क्लाइम दैट हायर स्टेप वन नीड्स एनर्जी दैट कम्स फ्रॉम द अभ्यास बिकॉज अभ्यास एक्ट्स लाइक अ फ्यूल. एट द सेम टाइम अनलेस यू हैव द एबिलिटी टू लीव द लोअर स्टेप्स you cannot rise up, isn't it? So hence detachment is also necessary. So jaise jaise hum higher knowledge ko paane lagte hain the lower tendencies which pulls us down disconnected and that is vairagya. See, this abhyas and vairagya are like, you know, two wings of the bird who is aspiring to fly higher and higher to that ultimate freedom. Ultimate freedom in the sky, you may say. As we were discussing long back in Bhagavad Gita, I think in the sixth chapter, the shlok which is there, I think shlok number 34, if I am remembering, because I always include this in my lectures. Chanchalam hi mana Krishna pramati balvadrana pasyaham nigraham manye ayor eva sudushkaram. Arjun keh raha hai Krishna se, मन बहुत चंचल है हे कृष्णा, इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू कंट्रोल दिस माइंड. जिद्दी है ये, बलवान है ये, इसको कंट्रोल में लाना, इसका निग्रह करना मानो जैसे हवा को पकड़ने जैसा. कृष्ण जैसे माता पिता छोटे बच्चे की कंप्लेंट के ऊपर मुस्कुरा देते हैं और कहते हैं ना, वैसे भगवान कृष्ण भी कहते हैं, असंशयम महाबाहो मनो दुर्निग्रहम कलम, अभ्यास न तु कौन्तेय वैराग्य न च ब्रूयते. भगवान बोल देते हैं, हे महाबाहो, ओ अर्जुना, दो दिस माइंड इज वेरी फिकल, वेरी एंड दो इट इज डिफिकल्ट टू ब्रिंग इट अंडर, आई एक्सेप्ट, आई अंडरस्टैंड योर प्रॉब्लम, बट एट द सेम टाइम ओ सन ऑफ कुंती, एज ही सेज ना, अभ्यास ही नहीं तो कुंती, कुंती सन ऑफ कुंती, द अभ्यास एंड वैराग्य, इफ यू आर ब्रिंगिंग दिस टू यू विल बी एबल टू मैनेज योर माइंड, योर स्टेट ऑफ चित्त, यू कैन से. सो हियर एज वी आर अंडरस्टैंडिंग Can you all hear me? Yes. I lost internet for a while. Wondering what happened. So, all said and done, we need to understand the view of Vyasa Muni in Vyasa Bhashya. He says, Chitta is like a river. Chitta is a nadi. Chitta is like a river. And it is flowing in both the directions, he says. Towards virtue as well as towards evilness. Towards liberation as well as towards bondage. So, ye ek aisi nadi hai which flows in both the directions. In our normal case, the river generally flows downward due to gravity, isn't it? Towards the ocean. Or you can say towards down. In the very similar manner, our senses and the mind, friends, they are always gravitating towards the world. Duniyadari ki taraf aakarshit rehte hain. Whereas yoga, yoga is that process through which it is like we are swimming through the same river and going moving ahead. The same chitta, being in yoga, you are like swimming against the tide, against the current. Actually, you are flowing or swimming towards the source of the river, source of the chitta. And that source of the chitta is nothing but Chiti Shakti, the pure consciousness. At one side, the renunciation, or you can say the Vairagya, is preventing the downward movement. So, against the gravity, Abhyasa helps. So, every individual thus identifies himself with chitta vrittis and knows that this chitta vrittis is like covering his true self. It is like an aura on the true self. The chitta vrittis is covering it. There is this state of consciousness which we say I-ness or ego is created. So an individual or a man creates a web of me, mine, mera, mera ghar, mera paisa, mere bacche, meri gaadi, and he totally gets caught up in these things. But here the abhyas and vairagya, which has been Gita as well as in Yoga Sutra, is like, you know, a double-edged sword. दोनों दूधारी तलवार जो उसके समान है ये लिटरली ईयर्स ऑफ एवरी काइंड ऑफ ऑब्स्टिकल एंड लीड्स यू अहेड एंड ही सेज तत्र सिद्धौ यत्नो अभ्यास अभ्यास वैराग्याभ्याम अनिरोधः यू कैन ब्रिंग द सीजेशन with the help of abhyas and vairagya. ये तो बता दिया ना. अब वो कह रहे हैं कि अभ्यास क्या है. तत्र सितो यत्न. यत्न is that effort. That effort which helps you to stay in that state of cessation or the state of silence is अभ्यास. आपके एफर्ट से चलते रहने चाहिए ना. दैट इज अभ्यास. ही सेज अंजलि इज वेरी क्लियर इन हिज अंडरस्टैंडिंग इट इज नॉट ओनली जस्ट अभ्यास बट कंटिन्यूअस और कॉन्स्टेंट प्रैक्टिस और कॉन्स्टेंट एफर्ट टू स्टे इन दैट स्टेट ऑफ चित्तवृत्ति निरोध. द एफर्ट दैट यू आर पुटिंग इज नथिंग बट अभ्यास. एक्चुअली सही मानों में जब मैं कहता हूं ना कि वी नीड टू स्टे इन दैट स्टेट ऑफ साइलेंस द स्टेट ऑफ चित्तवृत्ति निरोध आई फील दैट वी प्रैक्टिस दिस स्टेट ऑफ साइलेंस एवरी डे एवरी मोमेंट एज वी ब्रीथ इन एंड ब्रीथ आउट. आप बोलेंगे सर कभी नहीं, हमने तो कभी एक्सपीरियंस नहीं किया. बट लेट मी टेल यू वन थिंग. As you inhale and then you exhale, between that inhalation and exhalation, there is a gap of fraction of second. आपने इनहेल किया, सांस ली, फिर आप सांस छोड़ते हैं. तो सांस लेने के बाद जब सांस छोड़ने की बारी आती है, there is this gap. Though it may be usually lasting for a fraction of second or less than that, it is not noticed, isn't it? We are not. You say, "Nahi sir, humne kabhi aisa experience nahi kiya." But this is because our mind is moving too fast. So it is responsible. It is impossible to recognize this state of silence. This two, inhalation and exhalation. This is also a mental modification. The first thing that we are supposed to do is slow down. अपने सांस को. The simple Om chanting which we do. You inhale, and then when you exhale. Or conscious breathing you do. You are inhaling for 5 seconds and slowly exhaling for 5 seconds. Usually, even at the rest period, we are breathing at least 12 to 13 breaths in a minute. Even in complete rest state. When you sleep, almost 8 to 10. When I am active, I am speaking 14 to 15 or 16, 17. If we do that 5 counts inhalation, 10 seconds mein ek breath ho gaya. You just imagine in that whole 1 minute we have done only 6 breaths. So kaha 15, kaha 12, kaha 8, 10. We have come down to only 6 now. In the very similar manner, if we carefully observe our thoughts, we may see more or less some kind of thoughts always. Thinks about, like worrying about the children or thoughts about the children, will occupy his mind most of the time. If a person is attached to money, continuously is thinking about save money, where to invest, and so on. So the stronger the attachment, the movement of the mind is going on very fast, as a magnet creates pulling sensations, or you can say a magnetic field around it. In the very similar manner, various attachments create a field in the mind which moves continuously. Hence, we need to understand that attachment being in full force, only detachment is the key to slow down. Slow down that thought processes. So the first step in that is to overcome the forces of likes and dislikes. मुझे ये पसंद है, मुझे ये पसंद नहीं है, मुझे ये अच्छा लगता है, मुझे ये अच्छा नहीं लगता. Here, friends, when our mental movements slow down, one start observing that gap, one starts perceiving the state of silence between the two modifications or mental modifications, and an effort here to stay in that silence between the two is said to be abhyasa. और ये जो पूरी बहिरंग योग साधना जो है, अष्टांग योग के अंदर बहिरंग योग और अंतरंग योग है, तो बहिरंग योग में यम नियम आसन प्राणायाम प्रत्याहार आता है, जो हम सेकंड चैप्टर में पढ़ने वाले हैं. दिस बहिरंग साधना, बहिरंग योग साधना, इट कंट्रोल्स अवर मेंटल एक्टिविटी. एंड द अंतरंग योग साधना हेल्प्स वन to become established in the state of peacefulness of mind. और ये अभ्यास के लिए उन्होंने अगले सूत्र में क्या कहा, सतु दीर्घकाल नैरंतर्य सत्कार आसेवितः दृढ़ भूमि. इस एफर्ट दैट वी आर पुटिंग, तो हम प्रयास करते रहे ना, एफर्ट टू कंट्रोल द माइंड दैट वी आर पुटिंग इन, ही गिव्स अ डेफिनेशन, और यू कैन से इट टेल्स अस द थ्री इंपॉर्टेंट प्रिंसिपल्स विच शुड बी इंक्लूडेड इन अवर प्रैक्टिस टू सक्सेस. सो कंटिन्यूड फॉर अ लॉन्ग टाइम, दीर्घ काल, निरंतर, without any break, without any interruption, satkar asevitah, with great enthusiasm and devotion. So aur aage bolte hain dridh bhumi, to ye jo efforts hum dal rahe hain, this will lead to a kind of firm foundation, dridhta, bhumi, foundation. So continuous practice without any break and with great devotion, our abhyasa is going to have a firm foundation. So here, these three important principles, one must be able to imbibe throughout his lifelong practice without any break. That's what I always say, na. Yoga sadhana is not confined to an hour or 2 hours of practice a day. Just imagine, I'm giving an example. If you want to silence your mind for 5 minutes, the rest of the 23 hours, 55 minutes will matter a lot. Because that will lay a foundation. That will lay a foundation to that silencing of the mind for 5 minutes. So, yoga ka abhyas sirf wo 5 minute ka nahi hua. योग का अभ्यास पूरे 24 घंटे का हो गया और इसके लिए हमको पूरी अपनी लाइफस्टाइल मोल्ड करनी पड़ेगी. द होल द एंटायर लाइफ इज टू बी ब्रॉट अंडर दैट काइंड ऑफ डिसिप्लिन. एंड यू नो वेर एवर देर इज अ ब्रेक इन द प्रैक्टिस ब्रिंग्स अबाउट स्टैग्नेशंस. Frankly telling you, friends, your practice time is decided between morning 5:30 to 6:30. Every day morning you are coming to. किसी दिन आपकी तबीयत ठीक नहीं है, पिछले दिन की थकान है, कुछ भी है. अब ये सूत्र पढ़ने के बाद में एक एहसास हो जाना चाहिए कि कुछ भी हो जाए मैं प्रैक्टिस नहीं करूंगा. But at least I will give that period of my devotion. At least I will bring about patience in order to be dedicated for that time, even if I am not practicing. See, this is human nature. You are not feeling good, so you are not practicing. You are not feeling well. You are having a fever, so you are not practicing. Agreed. लेकिन अगर उस समय आप रोजाना अभ्यास करते हैं तो वो समय उस हालत में भी आप अपने आप को जो है ना कुछ ना करते हुए भी इन्वॉल्व करने की. आप बोलेंगे सर ये तो मुश्किल है. आई एग्री मुश्किल है लेकिन इम्पॉसिबल नहीं है. सी आई अंडरस्टैंड इट इज वेरी टफ. बहुत ठंडी लग रही होगी तो सुनील भाई नहीं नहीं यहाँ पे गुरुग्राम के अंदर जो है ठंड का एहसास बहुत है मैं नहीं कर रहा. आशुतोष सर बोलेंगे या पूना में बहुत गर्मी हो रही है आज मैं पसीना पसीना हो गया हूँ सुबह मैं नहीं कर रहा है. तो दिया आपने एग्रीड. दिस इज योर नेचर विच इज प्रॉम्प्टिंग यू स्किप द प्रैक्टिस बट दिस इज योर नेचर ऑफ मटेरियल अफेयर्स. Think about the nature of conscious affairs. That consciousness should make you see. This is always is going to be a habit formation thing, friends. जब तक हमने अपने आप को इस लेवल पे नहीं लाया ना और वो हैबिट नहीं किया ना तो स्किल है. And whenever we do anything for a long time, it becomes a habit. And they say. Habit is your second nature. A very ardent student of yoga, very devoted, dedicated student of yoga, will become the part and parcel of the second nature, habit. So this is what I understand from that word dridhu. That is where you are laying a foundation for yourself to be in that practice incessantly. ये आप लोगों ने कितनी बार कहा कि हम सुबह एक घंटे की प्रैक्टिस करते लेकिन पूरा दिन अच्छा जाता है. सुबह एक घंटे की प्रैक्टिस करते लेकिन पूरा जो है योग की फीलिंग बनी रहती है. जिस दिन आपने स्किप किया शायद योग की फीलिंग बनी रहती है, ये डाउट हो जाता है। लेकिन आपने उस एक घंटे में कुछ ना करते हुए सिर्फ ये अवेयरनेस में रहे कि भले मैं कुछ नहीं कर रहा हूं, आई एम जस्ट रेस्टिंग, बट आई एम इमेजिनिंग, आई एम जस्ट लुकिंग एट अदर पीपल, तो आई एम नॉट डूइंग एनीथिंग फिजिकली, मेंटली आई एम इन्वॉल्व, दैट बिकम्स दृढ़ भूमि। हाउ द प्रैक्टिस बिकम्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। तो ये था अभ्यास की, और उन्होंने कहा अभ्यास वैराग्य अभ्यास अलोंग विथ वैराग्य। तो वैराग्य के बारे में वो दृष्टानुश्रविक विषय विदृष्टस्य वशिकार संज्ञा वैराग्यम, दृष्टा अनुश्रविक विषय विदृष्टस्य वशिकार संज्ञा वैराग्यम। विषय वितृष्णस्य व्हेन द थर्स्ट फॉर एनी ऑब्जेक्ट दृष्टा सीन अनुश्रविक हर्ड ऑफ, सो व्हेन द थर्स्ट फॉर एनी ऑब्जेक्ट सीन और हर्ड वैनिशेस वितृष्णस्य वैराग्यम टेक्स प्लेस, द स्टेट ऑफ टोटल डिजायरनेसनेस, the state of desirelessness, or I should say total desirelessness. Why? Because he says vashikar, vashikar vairagya. According to Vyas Bhashya friends, when the mind becomes indifferent to worldly objects, opposite sex, towards food, towards drinks, towards power, and remains disinterested that too with a state of complete state of peaceful mind, or you can say as described in the scriptures, or having heard in the discourses, satsang, this detachment, this state of detachment is known as vashikara. And this will come through a state of discriminative knowledge, the viveka. Jnana yoga mein sadhana chatustaya ki baat ki gayi hai, viveka vairagya shat sampatti, aur uske baad mein mumukshutva. So how from viveka we lead ourselves towards mumukshutva, the intense desire to attain moksha, is very well explained. Through this discriminative knowledge, one has to understand that the enjoyment associated with the worldly objects seen or heard is temporary, or you can say is transitory, but they are not at all in any way comparable to the bliss and the silence which is experienced in the higher state or the higher states of consciousness. So an individual, once he experiences the higher states of consciousness, will regularly give up the lower pleasures for the sake of this experience. Here in this sutra, when we say drushtanushravika vishay krishnasya, Krishna, the word is very important here, friends. It means no thirst for object. But we should be very clear here, no thirst doesn't mean suppression. It doesn't mean the suppression of desires. But sublimation of desires is what it means. So sublimation mein aur suppression mein sabhi aasman ka suppress karna, kab wo volcano banke phat padega pata nahi. when you are doing it with sublimation, you are doing lot of good to yourself for that spiritual progress. And let me tell you, वैराग्य, जैसे हम किसी किसी को वैरागी बोलते हैं ना. यस सर, प्लीज कमिंग.
व्हेन वी से वित्रिष्णा, नाउ वी यू आर सेइंग देयर आर टू पॉसिबिलिटीज, सप्रेशन एंड सब्लिमेशन. आई एम सेइंग देयर इज अ थर्ड पॉसिबिलिटी, दैट इज सेशिएशन. बिकॉज व्हेन आई हैव थर्स्ट, I have to drink water in order to fulfill the thirst. So, Vitrishna can mean also that I am satiated.
Yes, of course. But when you are saying satiated, in what context, sir? I get satiated by eating that jalebi because there was a desire to have it and I feel satiated there. We are talking about that Vitrishna, which is not about the worldly to get satiated, but to think about that consciousness which will lead me towards higher states of consciousness. So we are talking of that. See, when I was telling, when I say I like this, so I want to have this, I am happy because I am having it. You said, sir, I am feeling thirsty, so I drink water, I feel satiated. But this is aspect towards the worldliness, towards the matter, towards the desires of the body. Whatever you desire, you have it and you feel satiated, isn't it? We are not talking about that. We are talking about Vitrishna. To overcome this experience of, we can say, fake bliss. The word satiated means somewhat kind of aha, pyaas bujh gayi, achha laga. This is also a bliss in material understanding. But at the same time, truly we have to understand bliss with spiritual point of view, which is not connecting us to the material experiences, but is connecting us to the spiritual experiences. So here, Vairagya literally doesn't mean that you have to leave your family and seek some solitariness or solitude. Not at all. A yogi who is into the practice of yoga has no desire for the worldly objects, friends. Or बहुत पहले व्हेन आई वाज स्टूडेंट, योग सूत्र का योग भाष्य और महाभाष्य इज रिटन बाय व्यास मुनि एंड ऑन दिस महाभाष्य स्वामी हरिहरानंद आरण्य हैज रिटन डाउन पब्लिश्ड बाय मोतीलाल बनारसी लाल दिल्ली. इतना मोटा बुक है. He says that there are three steps to this Vashikara Sanya, the total mastery on Vairagya, which we are talking about. So Vashikara Sanya, and the first step is Yatamana Vairagya. What is Yatamana? It is like, you know, consciously, with alertness, you are trying to reduce all the strong pulls towards sensual objects. जैसे कि मैंने थोड़ी देर पहले एग्जांपल दिया कि आप मिठाई की दुकान पर रास्ते से गुजरते हैं तो आप जुबो आती है और मन के अंदर वो इच्छा पैदा होती है कि जलेबी खाना है. लेकिन अंदर से एक समझ भी आती है, अरे साबिर डायबिटीज है ना, नहीं खाना चाहिए. सो एक्सेप्ट इट. नाउ दैट इज यतमान वैराग्य. Then there is Vyatireka Vairagya. Our sense organs, they are always involved. into सेंस ऑब्जेक्ट्स, आंख से देखना, कान से सुनना, जीभ से टेस्ट करना. When we say व्यतिरेक वैराग्य, you can literally say a kind of they are completely taken away from the objects. The senses are taken away from them. That is व्यतिरेक वैराग्य. और फिर उसके बाद में तीसरा स्टेप उन्होंने बताया एकेंद्रीय वैराग्य. एकेंद्रीय, एकेंद्रीय वैराग्य. In that एकेंद्रीय वैराग्य, say that your sensual attachment has been taken care of. If even if it is there, only a very feeble, gentle, minor, minute, attenuated tendency remains. It is ekendriya vairagya. And then the vairagya which has been as vashikara sanya, a total mastery. Even those attenuated mental tendencies are supported. Uska bhi khatma ho jana chahiye. A state of absolute indifference to the objects of the world should be developed. Aur ye sab cheezon ke sath sath hamare rozmarra ki zindagi mein bhi. जैसे कि जब आशा मैडम भगवत गीता के श्लोक के साथ मीनिंग समझाती हैं, तो आफ्टर लिसनिंग टू दोस पावरफुल वर्ड्स आई फील लाइक रिनाउंसिंग द वर्ल्ड इटसेल्फ. क्या रखा है इस दुनिया में, क्या लाया था, क्या लेके जाया, खाली हाथ आया है, खाली हाथ जाना है, ऐसा फीलिंग आ जाता है. तो मैं ऐसा बोलूंगा ये भगवत भगवत गीता वाला वैराग्य है. सो एनी टेक्स्ट मेकिंग अस मोटिवेटेड टू गो बियॉन्ड एंड गेट बिकम डिटैच्ड, इट इज लाइक अटेनिंग दैट वैराग्य. यू नो देयर इज वन वैराग्य by Swami Ananda Rishi, who has written down a sutra. He talks about prasava vairagya, prasava delivery of the child. So after delivering the child, you know, the lady feels as if completely detached from sexual attractions, you can say. After going through that period of delivery of the child, she comes to that kind of conclusion, ki na re baba. So such kind of things have been also.
It's also called some kind of depression. They go through some kind of depression.
Yes, yes.
Sometimes.
Yes, yes. They say postpartum depression. So that is also there. और एक जो मैं हमेशा आप लोगों को बताता हूं पहले, स्मशान वैराग्य. सो जब हम कोई चीता को लेकर जाते हैं स्मशान में, उसको अग्नि देते हैं, उसका अंतिम संस्करण सब कुछ कर देते हैं, तो हमको वहां स्मशान में बैठे बैठे से हमको भी एक दुनिया आना है. क्या रखा है इस दुनिया में, एक दिन हमको भी देह को पाना है. And it is going to come any time to us. I am standing here in this mashana now. The next day I may be brought here for the same. So, सोचते ही वहाँ पर जो है ना feeling. लेकिन ये temporary detachment. See, वो मशान की gate के बाहर आता है, ट्रिंग ट्रिंग करके उसका mobile phone बजता है, and he gets involved into the all worldly affairs and forgets about whatever mashan. Vairagya was there. So here we should understand Vashikara Vairagya is something which means giving up all and everything in this world, and that too temporarily, forever. Nahi to ye temporary ho gaya, smashan vairagya, prasava vairagya, मैडम का लेक्चर सुना, मोटिवेट हो गया, वो एक वैराग्य, ये सब टेम्पररी वैराग्य। यू नीड टू बिकम एस्टैब्लिश्ड एंड पतंजलि इज टॉकिंग अबाउट दैट एस्टैब्लिशमेंट ऑफ वशिकार वैराग्य, कंप्लीट कंट्रोल, कंप्लीट मास्टरी, दैट इज वशिकार। एंड देन ही डजंट स्टॉप हियर। एक तो वशिकार वैराग्य के बारे में उन्होंने कहा, इमीडिएटली नेक्स्ट सूत्र में वो कहते हैं तत्परम पुरुष ख्यातिर गुण वितृष्ण्यम। तत्परम पर वैराग्य क्या है, परम वैराग्य क्या है, गुण वैतृष्ण पुरुष ख्याते। सो ही इज टॉकिंग अबाउट गेनिंग द नॉलेज ऑफ द पुरुष बाय बिकमिंग टोटली गुणातीत, by going beyond the gunas. So here, awareness of that Purusha principle, a practitioner, a sadhaka, becoming totally indifferent to these gunas, the kind of detachment he comes to is nothing but paravairagya. If Vashikara Vairagya means Para Vairagya is like detachment from the inner world. Yes, inner world means Sattva Rajya Tama ka nature ke saath mein jina, not even getting totally impressed by the world, but still living in this body, going through that conscience. कि आई एम अ गुड पर्सन, आई शुड लीड माई लाइफ, आई 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 आ जाता है, भले वो सात्विक हो, सत्व तो है ना, सत्व इज ऑल्सो वन ऑफ द गुणास ओनली ना, मे बी द सत्व इज डॉमिनेटिंग ओवर दैट रज एंड तम, बट दैट अंडरस्टैंडिंग आई एम द बॉडी और द सेंसेस और द इंटेलेक्ट, वी हैव टू एलिमिनेट टोटली. It is like total isolation, isolation from Prakruti. Prakruti is nothing but Trigunas. So here, as we have read it in Bhagavad Gita also, because of the Trigunas, this mind is ever changing. In fact, these Trigunas uses a kind of, you know, foundation to experience the world, and to overcome this, that vivekti is essential, discriminative knowledge is essential. So to bring about this paravairagya, this discriminative knowledge, purusha khyate, the state of understanding towards Chiti Shakti, who is none other than the pure witness, we can say, passive witness. So here, we need to continuously be in that interaction between the gunas and going through a phase of practice leading us into the awareness of Purusha is Purusha Khyati. The thirst of the gunas will vanish. See, to lead us to this thirstless state of gunas will happen through only sattva. We have to transcend the dominancy of tama and raja and try to exist and prevail in sattva for a prolonged period. And that is where we can say guna vaitrushnam. This will lead to the isolation with Purusha, Brahman, Ishwar, whatever you say, and getting isolated from Prakriti, not at all in connection with Prakriti. So this kind of supreme detachment is going to eliminate all the latent impressions here. the state of samadhi also, tell you the latent emotions. These samskaras, they are having the ability to again and again. और इसी वजह से जो है हम दुनिया के साथ में कनेक्टेड रहते हैं. Now, since in the state of the whole world has vanished, reappears when one comes out of it. जैसी समाधि से बाहर आए, ये मैं सभी समाधि की बात कर रहा हूं, जैसे समाधि से बाहर आए एवरीथिंग इज अवेलेबल फॉर यू. सो जस्ट सभी जो समाधि डज नॉट एंश्योर्स लिबरेशन फॉर अस. अ ट्रू योगी देयरफॉर नेवर रेस्ट टिल द होल कंटेंट ऑफ द माइंड इज वाइप्ड आउट, इट्स इंप्रेशंस आर रिमूव्ड. When the last traces, friends, of attachment are said to be eliminated, and this is paravairagya. Guruji ki ek story yaad aa rahi hai. Mere paas samay kam rehta hai, aur mujhe 25 session mein पूरा योग सूत्र कंप्लीट करना है. साबिर भाई के दिल के अंदर ऐसे मचलते हुए कभी कभी चीजें आ जाती है. गुरुजी ने एक वैराग्य का एग्जांपल दिया था. एक गांव था, वहां पर साबिर के जैसा एक योगी रहा करता. साबिर को योगी बना दिया उन्होंने, ऐसे मेरा नाम लेके कह दिया उन्होंने. तो मैंने सर पे हाथ लगाया, मैं बोला सर नहीं, you just imagine Sabir is a great yogi and he is residing in a village and he is doing his sadhana. Wo subah sham wo nadi kinare apne nahane dhone ka karya kar raha hai Sabir bhai, aur apni sadhana mein badi dedication. Usi gaon ke andar ek bahut khoobsurat mahila thi. A very beautiful woman used to stay in that village. The whole village were like, you know, mad after her. लेकिन उस लेडी ने ये देखा कि साबिर भाई उसको बिल्कुल घास ही नहीं डालते, उसको भाव भी नहीं देते, उसकी तरफ देखते भी नहीं. अब वो लेडी का ईगो हो गया. उसने कई तरीके से साबिर भाई को भटकाने की कोशिश की, लेकिन साबिर भाई योगी थे ना भाई, मस से मस नहीं हुए. उन्होंने बड़े प्यार से उस महिला से कहा, जैसे विवेकानंद जी ने कहा कि आई वॉन्ट टू मैरी यू, तो ही सेड व्हाई, तो शी सेड very handsome child like you. उसी समय विवेकार्जुन ने कहा कि now you accept me as your child, you are my mother. Immediately. तो साबिर भाई ने भी कह दिया, माते मदर, अगर मेरे से कुछ गलती हो गई हो तो माफ कर, लेकिन प्लीज मेरे रास्ते में आप मत आओ, ये आपके पैतरे जो भी हैं वो मेरे साथ, आई एम गेटिंग डिस्टर्ब, प्लीज डोंट डू दिस. ऐसा कहने के बाद में वो औरत को लगा, शी स्टॉप्ड. उसने कहा ठीक है, मैं तुमको परेशान नहीं करूंगी, मान लिया. लेकिन साबिर भाई एक बात बताइए, क्या तुमको महिलाओं के बिल्कुल अट्रैक्शन नहीं है? साबिर भाई उस समय आप क्या बोले, क्या जवाब, क्योंकि वो अट्रैक्शन वाली बात कभी उनके मन में आई नहीं थी. साबिर भाई ने कहा, आई विल डेफिनेटली आंसर योर क्वेश्चन, मैं तुम्हारे सवाल का जवाब जरूर दूंगा, लेकिन मुझे कुछ समय चाहिए, बट मेरे रास्ते में आप नहीं आना, जरूर एक ना एक दिन तुम्हारे सवाल का जवाब दूंगा। साल निकल गए, दोनों बूढ़े हो गए, साबिर भाई भी बूढ़े हो गए, मैं भी बूढ़ी हो गई, साबिर भाई का देहांत का समय आ गया। साबिर भाई ने अपने एक सहयोगी से कहा, जाकर वो महिला को बुला कर लाओ, उसका एड्रेस वगैरह सब बता दिया। और जैसी वो सहयोगी महिला के पास पहुंचे, महिला के ऐसी बात आती कि इतने दिनों से तो मुझे मेरी याद नहीं आई थी, लेकिन आज क्यों अचानक याद आ गई, लगता है उसका माइंड चेंज हो गया, साबिर भाई को कुछ ना कुछ उसके दिमाग में आ गया, ऐसे लगा उसको। और वो सब काम धाम सब छोड़ी और निकल के चल पड़ी, और जैसे ही साबिर भाई के पास पहुंचती है तो साबिर भाई फिर से हाथ जोड़कर कहते हैं, माय डियर मदर, यू हैड आस्क्ड मी दैट क्वेश्चन एंड आई हैड प्रॉमिस्ड यू दैट आई विल आंसर इट सम डे, नाउ सिंस आई एम गोइंग टू डाई सो लेट मी गिव यू द आंसर। And the answer was given was, I was never attracted to any female. It never came into my mind. What is female? Who is female? What kind of object she is? Why she is existing on this earth? Nothing ever came to my mind. ये कौन कहते हैं? साबिर भाई योगी। वो महिला कहती है, यही बात उस दिन कह देना था ना, Why didn't you said to me on that day? आज क्यों बोल रहे हो? 40 साल निकल जाने के बाद मैं भी बूढ़ी हो गई, तुम भी बूढ़े हो गए, मरने जा रहे हो, और अभी तुम बोल रहे हो कि मैं किसी में इंटरेस्टेड ही नहीं था, इसलिए भी इंटरेस्ट नहीं थी, आज क्यों बोल रहे हो? Why didn't you tell me that time? तुम तभी भी तो बोल सकते थे। ये ऐसी परीक्षा की घड़ी होती है कि कब इंसान अपने साधना से डगमगा जाए, विश्वामित्र का ठिकाना नहीं रहा, वो डगमगा गया, तो मैं कौन से झाड़ पत्ती की मूली हूं। आज इस being on my deathbed, now I can tell you with certainty that I was never interested. Otherwise, in my next years, if I have become interested, so I would not have been fit to give you that right reply. But today on the deathbed, since I have never come across such kind of feelings for any women as such, I can tell you that I was not having any feeling for you. तो वो योगी ने देखो उस समय जवाब भी नहीं दिया, क्योंकि उसको मालूम है गुनास कैन डू चेंजेस एनी टाइम एंड दिस विल लीड टू ए काइंड ऑफ ग्रेट डिस्टर्बेंसेस एंड दिस कैन हैपन विद एवरीवन, तो मैं कौन सी खेत की मूली हूं। सो फ्रेंड्स, हियर द स्टोरीज, staying in that constant awareness of purusha, complete detachment of, or you can say the other things about gunas, is ensured. This is para vairagya, which alone will lead to that liberation. संन्यास क्या है, योगी कौन है, किस तरह से ये किया जा सकता है. सो दिस इज ए ब्यूटिफुल प्रिपरेशन टुवर्ड्स दैट इनवर्ड वेयर वी आर ऑलवेज रिमेनिंग अंडर दैट कॉन्स्टेंट अवेयरनेस ऑफ. नाउ फ्रेंड्स वंस दिस अभ्यास एंड वैराग्य इज प्रैक्टिस इट विल लीड टू सम रिजल्ट इजंट इट. And that result, he says, sampragnyata. Sampragnyata samadhi. Vitarka, vichara, ananda, anugamata, sampragnyataha. Vitarka, vichara, ananda. Sampragnyataha means samadhi with pragnya. When I'm talking about samadhi with pragnya, that samadhi which is having the knowledge or accompanied by vitarka. Vitarka is like reasoning. Tarka vitarka jo hum karte hain, reasoning. Vichara, doing reflection, thoughts. Ananda is the ultimate bliss, or you can say a bliss of the experience of the truth or getting proximity to the truth. That is the case. Aaj bhi hum jab yoga abhyas karte hain, ek ghante ke liye kiya nahi kiya, humko aisa lagta aha kitna acha lag raha hai. That is also a feeling of bliss. Vitarka vichara ananda aage kehte asmita, I consciousness. Anugamata sampragnyata, accompanied by this kind of samadhi is sampragna. So samadhi with pragna, samadhi profound knowledge or wisdom of vitarka vichara. Vitarka is reasoning, vichara is reflection, ananda that happiness, that bliss, I consciousness asmita. Now with that continuous practice of abhyasa and vairagya, we are actually eliminating all the mental distractions. And then the yogi is able to focus his mind on any object. One pointed mind knows that object in all perspective, you can say, by all means. The word sampragnyata here, it literally means that ultimate of that subject. See, we also see the objects around us. I can say these leaves are green, but within that leaves, if I go stand, do I know anything now? No. But in samadhi, through that vitarka, through that vichara, through that ananda, one will lead himself into that pure consciousness, pure I-ness, that is asmita. So one I-consciousness is the identification that you can say impure I-consciousness, impure asmita, jo aage hum jaake klesh mein padne wale, kleshas, avidya asmita, wo asmita, impure, pure understanding of consciousness. So, when a mind is focused on an object, first the gross aspect of that object is known. Knowing the gross aspect is known as savitarka. And going beyond that knowing of the grossness of the object is known as nirvitarka. Ye sab unhone aage explain kiya hai. From 41, we start and go ahead, he explains. Nirvitarka, savichara, nirvichara, sananda, sasmita. But here we need to understand that when the mind is focused on an object, first the gross state of that object is understood. And this is known as savitarka. The knowledge acquired during this savitarka state depends upon the whole external gross sensations received by the mind through the senses. So the name, the form of the object and its other peculiarity. Like जैसे समझो एक गुलाब का फूल मैंने एग्जाम्पल ले लिया ऑब्जेक्ट, तो उसका कलर, उसका शेप, उसकी खुशबू, ये सब जो है वितर्क में आ जाए. That distinguishes that object from the others. Object which we see in this world, like the animals, the trees, the leaves, the colors, are all gross objects. So any object, as I gave you the example of the flower, having many aspects, size, shape, and all, but it is known as a single entity. Na? So that knowledge is savitarka. But now with increased of concentration, if we are going into the subtler aspect of the same object, of the same lakka fool, we will be entering into the reflection. We will be entering into that knowledge or having that knowledge through reflection. And that reflection is known as vichara. In yogic knowledge, when we were discussing about the Sankhya point of view, the Tanmatra, the Pancha Mahabhutas are coming out. So here, the knowledge of the Tanmatras that constitute the grossness of that object is known in the concentrated form. In a depth form, internal form. In our modern language, we can say that the yogi who is doing samadhi on a particular sanyama, on a particular object, he is going into the molecular configuration of the same, which will give us the, you know, peculiar properties of that object. So going internal and trying to understand, ab hum yahan par to koi experiment to kar nahi rahe, khali ye mind se sara experience ho raha hai. The knowledge, the true knowledge is coming to us. So when these subtle aspects of an object are known, through this kind of mental analysis, vichara, you will be experiencing a state of bliss. And this state of bliss is nothing. This bliss arises with an understanding that whatever object I am focusing on, it's nothing but my own reflection. Yes. Because of that vichara, you are coming to this nirvichara state. And nirvichara state is like, you know, the objectivity of that object and yourself, they become one. There is no difference between the two. So whatever object I am focusing on is nothing but my own reflection, I say. A deep sense of oneness with the object results in this kind of, you know, unexplainable bliss. And this is the stage of ananda. It is free from vitarka or vichara. Vitarka, the grossness is gone. The reflection or the subtle thoughts gone. So when this thought processes is leading us to this transcendent understanding of the object, we are coming to the state of meditation. And this meditation is effortlessly acquired. And this feeling of bliss is experienced through this kind of meditation. So here, Sampragnyat Samadhi is like a journey from the gross to subtle to more inward to the eye consciousness, pure eye consciousness. And that is Asmita. So when that state of bliss is transcended from that state of ananda, only the awareness of the principle is known. That is eye consciousness. and I consciousness is pure intellect. And this is experiential self. Huh? Being in the three gunas, you are experiencing the self. Being in the state of sattva, you are literally seeing purusha. Seeing in the sense, not with the eyes. It cannot be seen. It cannot be observed. Or it cannot be felt. But it is only to be known and experienced. So pure eye consciousness is the state of sattva. That is asmita which we are talking about. And friends, here in this ultimate peak, the yogi is still going through the realm of sattva, raja, tama. Though the tama and raja is 0.001%. You can say like that, but they are there, still there. So when the content of our mind, or you can say the chitta, is full of sattva, it will literally act like a sattva. Aapke samne aina kaisa aapka aapko apna roop dikha. Isi tarah se aapka chitta itna pure ho jata hai, aapke eye consciousness ko, pure consciousness ka roop aapko dekhne milta hai. And that's the purusha. So here, it is said that we are experiencing purusha. And from this state, the yogi moves to asampragnyata samadhi. Through these various stages, savitarka, nirvitarka, savichara, nirvichara. Or second chapter, mein bata diya, seven steps. One is coming across and going beyond cognitive states of sampragnyata samadhi and coming to the state of asampragnyata. That state which is beyond this cognitive states. So this inward journey of consciousness comes to an end only and only when the yogi reaches the very source of the consciousness. And that is purusha. I wanted to complete asampragnyata at least today. But now asampragnyata we will be dealing more about in the next class. It is already 11:45. I just now saw it. So at least sampragnyata samadhi, samadhi with every kind of knowledge is understood. So let us stop here. Go ahead and wind up the session for the day. A discussion can be done after the ending.
Thank you, Guru.
पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णम् उदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णम् आदाय पूर्णम् एव अवशिष्यते ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः
Thank you.
Thank you.
Any questions, please ask before your discussion starts. Because not getting that opportunity. कि हमने decide करके रख लिया कि हर एक class के अंदर minimum 10 सूत्र complete करेंगे. तो आज हमने 12वें सूत्र से शुरुआत की और इस 17वें सूत्र तक ही हम कर सकते हैं. वह जो सूत्र है that is related to the अन्य और you can say असंप्रज्ञात समाधि that we will be discussing in the next. I hope you people are getting a grip about the same. All the examples I'm trying to bring in front of you and make you understand.
Actually, the program for today was up to 23rd sutra, which is a very big jump.
Huh? You know,
12 to 23. That is what your program said.
Yes.
Yeah.
So, listen, we understand.
I had tried to study. And I think that prior study helps. Otherwise, it's difficult to understand.
Yes.
Yeah. But M.R. Yardi's book